eve of your New Year's final show for 1975 of your five closest relatives, the mothers.
Right around the corner. Up through the night, and the whispering rain, to the place where call this stupid disease bromidrosis, and well they should. But us regular folks who might wear a tennis shoe or an occasional python, know this exquisite little inconvenience by the name of statehood. How true that is. You know my python boot was too tight. Couldn't get it off last night. A week went by and now it's July. I finally got it off and my girlfriend crying. Got statehood. Stink foot, darling. Your stinking foot. What's the hurts? On my nose. Stink foot. I ain't lying. Can you rinse it off, do you suppose? Well, here, Fido. Where is that dog? Where is that? Fido?
Yes, Frank?
Did you hear me? I asked you to bring my slippers.
Oh, Frank, I was so stoned. It's New Year and everything. I forgot to bring your slippers.
Don't you understand, Fido, that in a police state such as Los Angeles, a dog who does not comply with his master's wishes and who does not bring the aforementioned slippers when the slippers are requested, that dog in question is liable for punishment to the full extent of the law. Do you understand me, Fido?
Oh, yes, Frank. Hurt me.
Very well then, Fido. This will hurt me more than it hurts you. Ah, yes, that's more like it. God made the light. shortly thereafter, God, and we all know who we're talking about here, God made the poodle. When the poodle was first constructed, it was a pretty nice looking dog. It had hair evenly distributed all over its charming canine type body. Then God made two big mistakes. The first one was called Man, and the second one was called Woo Man. Shortly after the construction of Woo Man, Woo Man looked at the man, and then in turn looked upon the poodle. Whereupon the Woo Man turneth to the man and said, "Sucker! Go get a job so you can make some money and buy me some scissors with which I may modify the aforementioned poodle, because I think he looks pretty crappy with hair evenly distributed all over his body. I must fix it." The man, in a plaintive effort to make sure that he was going to get some later that night, actually went out and got the job and got the money and got the poodle flipping scissors and had the audacity to bring these scissors back to the Woo Man. And when he wasn't looking, the Woo Man went to the poodle and took the scissors and clipped them upon the poodle in the snout area, streamlined the snout quite a bit, clipped a little bit in the lower torso region, but was careful to leave a tasteful, distinctive little pom-pom of fur on the end of the poodle's tail, as I will demonstrate. And then the Woo Man turned to the man and said, "Sucker, go back to work, get me yet another pair of scissors with which I may fine-tune and carefully and extremely and take care of business with and go to work, and I will do some more to the poodle because this dog is getting me hot." And she turned to the poodle and she said these words.
Come on, Richard. Shoo it.
chewing it for long, because ladies and gentlemen, this is a song from the Reuben and the Jets album, if we can defeat some of this feedback here. The name of this song is How Could I Be Such a Fool? Love was lost, you
Thank you. 7 minutes to go. Davey, true story, ladies and gentlemen. You might have read about this guy in the newspaper. One of the great Americans of our time. His name is Michael Kenyon, professionally known as the Illinois Enema Bandit. For the past 10 years, just outside of Chicago and in various other wonderful places, like Kansas and Oklahoma, and even Los Angeles a couple of times, Michael Kenyon has been responsible for a series of, well, here's what he does. He puts on a ski mask and he breaks into the home of a college-educated woman and at gunpoint forces the college-educated woman to submit to an enema. He carries with him a briefcase, and in the briefcase is the mask, the gun, some rope, the enema, and a thermometer. He ties the girls up, or he used to until I caught him, ties them up, sticks the thermometer in, pulls it out, checks their temperature, gives it a little tasteful little whiff, puts it away, dashes into the toilet with the enema bag, fills it up, runs back in, spreads the delicate buttock tissue, and shoves the nozzle in there, pumps her up with about 2 quarts, pulls it out, beats his meat, and tells her not to call the police for at least 5 minutes. Now, in these days of trials and tribulations, when statesmanship seems to be out to lunch and great Americans are hard to find, we have to nominate Michael Kenyon, who has just recently been convicted of these atrocities. He was sentenced to, I think, 6 consecutive terms of 12 years or something like that on the charge of armed robbery. Apparently there is no law against giving a college-educated woman an enema, but maybe next year. It goes like that.
Educated women, he'd be
the judge will have him. Girl is special, okay? The DA will order a secret test. Stuff his pudgy little thumbs in the side of his vest. Put out a call, hello, with the jury folks, that's you. And the judge will say, no poo-poo jokes. They'll drag in the bandit for all the scenes, saying, don't nobody, no, have no sympathy. Hot soapy water in the first degree. And the bandit might say,
why is everybody so happy?
Well, did you cry this misery? Well, did you cry this misery? Bandit, did you cry this misery? Well, one girl shall
leave the bandit.
It must be just what they all need. It must be just what they all need. Of course, it must be just what they all need. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we have this new song that we're going to do with the assistance of the lovely and talented L.A. Knockers dance troupe. This is a new song that is dedicated to the premise that every young boy should find out what he's doing before he goes out chasing after his favorite young girl. This information is also valuable to older boys and older girls because of the new value system that has been implanted in the American way of life. Now that the modern woman has made her appearance on the scene, now that there's a whole new trend to, well, you know, they're real good now, and so the guy's got to lay back a little bit and just pretend to be a chump a lot. So the name of this song is Dada Goo Goo, otherwise titled Find Her Finer, and it's an abject lesson for you. It goes like this.
Thank you. till you finally thank you.
Now, Davey, you're going to have to turn the drum monitors back. Just a little taste. Tex, thank you very much. That was a wonderful dance. We have another song with the Knockers if they've got their costume changed. Are the ladies ready? Well, this is Mr. Big Chin. Name of this song is Keep It Greasy, so it goes down easy.
Keep it greasy, so it go down easy. Keep it greasy, so it go down easy. Keep it greasy, so it go down easy. Roll it over and grease it down. I'll drive you through the heart of town. Keep it greasy, so it go down easy. Keep it greasy, so it go down easy. Sit down, I'll drive you through the heart of town. A good woman ain't short and handsome tough. It could be a world that just ain't enough. A good girl looking loose all the time. It could be the something that they can't find. But if they find one look down the street, they try to be another that they can be. Or if they find one and let it be good, chances are they might not never find it no more. So they keep it greasy, so go down in there. Keep it greasy, so go down in there. Keep it greasy, so go down in there. Roll it over and grease it down. I'll drive you through the heart of town. Grease it down.
very much.
Since we're in the house, it was a club step up.
New Year. I tell you to drive safely on the way home so you get to live for the rest of the year and enjoy it.
Yeah, I'm the sly oozing out from your TV.